Hey, welcome back to Trekking California with Velox 18. We are in Utah, and we're going to start out today's video by making a delivery. So, yeah, that's all we got to do. We're just going to start the video making a delivery. I guess you can roll the music now. We got our hours reset, and we're leaving St. George, Utah, headed back towards Las Vegas. So this, we got in kind of late this morning, last night, so it's 2 p.m. So we got in at 4 a.m. Mountain time, which would be like 1 a.m. Like 3 a.m. My time, Pacific time. So it was pretty late, man. Pretty late, and not ideal, but we made it work. And now we just gotta get over here to make our pickup. We have an 8:15 p.m. appointment at a Miracle in Henderson, Nevada. So I'm just heading that direction, and it's not like a through the night with a morning delivery like a lot of the ones that I've done over there are. So I can kind of take my time on it, so I'm going to, especially since I got in so late last night. It's better if I kind of take it easy on this load. So today we're just gonna head over to Vegas, take our time. We might have a pit stop, I'm not sure yet, but nevertheless, I'm just gonna start heading that direction, get out of Utah, get across that little corner of Arizona back into Nevada, and our load for tonight. So that's all we got going on the docket. We're gonna go through Virgin River Gorge, and Probably gonna show some more footage of that. I won't do the full thing. If you want to see the full video footage from a few weeks ago, I think last month I did a video where it's in the title of the video. You can see the whole Virgin River Gorge drive, and that was a fun video. It doesn't take very long to go through there, so I put the whole thing in there. But I'm not gonna do that this time. So let's trek it on down the road. Let's go. Over here at the Streakin Beacon. It's long past overdue. Once again, wash the truck, and we're behind this truck here. This was my first job I ever got out of after the tomato season for Morningstar. I worked for Ron Lawrence and Son, and ran as a company driver for them for about four and a half, five months, something like that, before I moved over to Silva Trucking. So anyway, it's kind of funny seeing their trailer in front of me. It's an owner-operator up there. It's not a company driver. It's not one of their trucks. They got like dark red trucks with like maroon fenders. Kind of a cool color setup. But yeah, anyway, there is a line. It took me about half an hour just to get into the driveway, but it's just before 4 o'clock, and I have an 8:15 appointment tonight, and so I really don't got anything else to do, so I might as well wait in line at the Beacon, get myself a truck wash. And it's supposed to rain this week, but all the more reason to get the stuff that's on there off of it now, because it's not gonna get cleaner by rain when it's this dirty, that's for dang sure. It's not gonna clean it off. So anyway, this is what we're doing, and let's see how long this takes. that done with the wash. And now we're gonna head over to Americold over in Henderson. It is currently 6 o'clock, so we 5:25, so we should be over there by 6 o'clock, and then we have an 8:15 appointment, but it's the night shift over there. It's a little different than day shift, so I have a feeling I could possibly maybe get loaded early if I get there before my appointment time. So I'm gonna give it a shot, and we'll get on down the road. Let's go. All right. Got checked in over here at Americold at 6:15 for my 8:15 appointment. And they told me back up to 34 and go check in. So they didn't put me on the side like they do sometimes. So that's good. That's a good sign, guys. It's a good sign. And we'll just flip around over here like we have done so many times. And get ourselves backed into, you don't back all the way into it when you first get here. You back up to it about 5 feet away from the dock and leave your doors closed so you can keep your temperature. The rate confirmation was like negative 20. Make sure you're at negative 20. You must be at negative 15 before you get there. And I'm like, I know that they didn't change the rules in the 2 weeks I haven't been here. It's, they want you to be at least negative 5. And then set for negative 10. Negative 10 or negative 15. Actually, now I'm forgetting. But I know that 5 is their cutoff. They don't want you to get into... they won't even put you in a door until you're at negative 5. So. Just swing it on in here. Back it on up. And we'll just stop a little bit short of the doors and go check in. All right, let's do this. Hopefully this doesn't take too long.
All right,
checked in. They said to stay right there with your doors closed. They'll come out and get you when they're ready to load you. They said your appointment's not till 8:15. So I think what she was saying is don't be surprised if they don't come out here before 8:15. But I don't even mind that. I'm just glad to be in the door, and whenever they load me, I'm sure it'll be a good night. The times I've been here during the night crew loading has been really good. So that's what I think is gonna happen. I got my little bandana face mask, walking like a bandit. All right. I'm gonna relax, chill, and maybe take a little bit of a nap. I don't know, we'll see. And then depending on what time I get out of here tonight will depend on how long I drive. So it's all up in the air, which isn't my favorite thing, but gotta do what we gotta do. Probably order some dinner right now from Uber Eats, get it delivered. I don't know, there's some stuff around here, but I don't want to go walk in to go get it and then have them come out and be ready to load me. So kind of one of those things where, like, I can walk to the end of the driveway and hustle back if they need to get me, but I don't want to miss my opportunity to get loaded because I walked down the street to go get food. All right, that's this update. The next update will be when we get loaded. All right, folks, we ordered some Uber Eats, and it's time. I'm like excited about this. I'm really excited about this, all right? Because it's time for El Gordo Velox.
El Gordo Velox! El Gordo Velox!
I ordered from a place called Straight from Philly. Alright? So guess what I ordered? That's right. Oh, it's so greasy. Oh, it's so good. It's gonna be so good, but so messy. I'm gonna have to like get some towels. Some beach towels for this stuff. I'm gonna have to figure something out real quick. Alright, hold on. Because this is so greasy. So phenomenal. Okay, you guys gotta see this. Hold on. Look at the whiz, guys. It's got provolone and whiz. Oh my gosh, that's gonna be so good. But I gotta figure out a way to eat it without wearing it. All right, so give me 1 second. All right, I got myself a grip of shop towels, a little thicker than a regular napkin. All right, I'm so excited about this. I'm hungry, guys, but I'm a little giddy right now. Like, this looks so scrumptious. You guys are gonna be so grossed out by how I eat this right now. If you're squeamish, you're not gonna want to watch this. Oh man. I gotta get you guys a better angle of this thing, because this is unreal. Alright. Honestly, there's no other way to do it. Oh, is it cut in half? It's cut in half. Oh, thank you, Straight from Philly, for cutting it in half. Makes it a much more manageable sandwich. But look at this. I can't even. Alright. Hide your children. Dude, that's so good. And the fact that it came from Uber Eats and it's still really hot. The meat is seasoned a decent amount, but you know, it's got mushrooms and onions and peppers, so that's where most of the flavor's coming from. And then you got 2 different types of cheeses. And basically, it's a heart attack on a bun. And I'm here for it. That makes a baker's dozen, Bob. All right? I'm going for a baker's dozen. Let's do this. A baker's dozen heart attacks. Coming right up. All right. We're going to cut this off because I got to finish this. And I'm actually trying to eat polite for you guys. Because right now I'm getting ready just like, lay off me. I'm starving. All right? All right? So we'll catch up with you guys when we get loaded. All right, whew. My goodness, that was amazing, dude. That was freaking amazing. That just hit the spot. I was really hungry, but that just hit the spot. Like, quenched my hunger, my craving for some diabetes. Some clogged arteries. Sorry. My mom's gonna hate that. She really hates, like, when I make light of eating unhealthy. Anyway, don't do that. It's bad. But if you're gonna have it every once in a while, that was pretty good. So they have, like, a North Philly, which has provolone, and they got a South Philly, which has whiz, cheese whiz, or vice versa. I forget. But I ordered the one with provolone, and then I asked them to add the whiz on, the cheese whiz, because that is That is Philadelphia, the whiz, man. You gotta have the whiz. So, and then of course onions. Onions are optional. I don't know why, but they say fried onions, yes or no, after you know, order, select the order, and I'm like, yes. Gotta have the onions, peppers, and the mushrooms to complete. I mean, it was so good. So good. I'm not a huge fan of mushrooms, but once you put it in there with the peppers, once you put it in everything together, dude, so bomb. So bomb. I think this whole video is just going to be me talking about these Philly cheesesteaks. But straight from Philly in Henderson, Nevada. If you guys are ever sitting around at a shipper or receiver in Henderson, Nevada, and you're waiting and you get hungry, and you can hop on your phone and, you know, get some Uber Eats over to where you're at and get yourself some Philly cheesesteak, because that was so unhealthy, but so good. Amazingly good. I have to just keep talking about it. I realized when I said the beach towel thing, that's like totally a Guy Fieri thing from the Food Network, from Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives. And I was like thinking about it afterwards. I'm like, why did I say that? Oh, that's straight up. I'm stealing from Food Network now. I'm stealing from Guy Fieri. Next thing I'm going to steal is, oh, you can eat that sauce on a flip-flop. But and then the bleached hair. I got to do the bleached hair, though. That someday I'll do the bleached hair, and I'll complete my impersonation of Guy Fieri. But for now, this is what you guys get. And man, that was good. I can't say it enough. All right, let's hope we get loaded pretty soon. It's about 6:30. No, I'm sorry, 7:30. So, you know, we still got a little bit of time. We got 45 minutes before our appointment time, so we're just chilling, not in a hurry. Nothing crazy happening yet. Not getting impatient yet. All right. We're just hanging out, chilling. Then I'm going to get back in the sleeper, kick my shoes off, and relax for a little bit. Upload some video. Upload this video. There you go. All right. We are loaded up. Loaded up. And it is only 8:12. Getting out of here before my appointment time even started. He came out. He said, hey, man, I already opened your doors. I'm like, wait, you did? He's like, yeah, I opened your doors. Back it up. I said, all right, cool. He goes, hey, it's not that many pallets, so have your shoes on. Be ready to get out of here. I'm like, all right. Sounds good to me. I like it. This place at night is way cooler than during the day. I'll just say that. It's much nicer. All right, we're gonna check out right here, and then we'll be gone. And let's see if they're I feel like their weight is off on the oh no, that's right, this was a lighter load. Yeah, 23,237 pounds. So I'm pretty stoked right now. That's an awesome load. And we're going to take this one to Gilroy, California. So it's a Unified Grocers, which is always a tough one. You know, they're not very smooth over there, Unified Grocers, a lot of times. But, you know, we're doing good on this end. So maybe it'll make up for it. So, yeah, let's get checked out. All right, we are trucking. It took a little while. They wrote down the wrong trailer number. I really got to get my vinyl guy Rigo to come over and get my vinyl lettering on this trailer, because they wrote down the wrong trailer number on my paperwork. So then that made it to where that made it to where I couldn't get out the gate. But while I was there, I got to meet a subscriber, Caesar. It was good meeting you, bro. Caesar from East LA. That's right. But yeah, he was truck driving for 15 years and then took a break, and now he's back at it. And of course, anytime you get a new job and you haven't been trucking for a little while, they want you to be with the trainer. So he's over there with the trainer, and I'll just tell you that the trainer was having a bad day. He had backed off the edge of a little bank and high pointed the tanks on the edge of the bank. And while I know that that's good content that people want to see, and they want to see people's bad days, it's not the kind of content I like to make. I don't like to get clicks off of people's bad days. It's just not my style. I try to get clicks off of my bad days sometimes. You know, I'll put my own self on blast, you know, for doing dumb stuff, or for not being able to figure out how to do a tire plug, you know, stuff like that. but I don't want to use someone else's misfortune or bad day to get my channel clicks. So anyway, so I didn't show you guys, but it was that was Caesar's trainer having a bad day. And then, but it gave us an opportunity. He was stuck there. I was stuck there waiting for them to fix my trailer situation. So me and him got to talk for a little while. So once again, good meeting you. Man, anytime we wash this thing, those hood mounts just squeak away. All right, that means we're going to have to cut this off right here, because that squeaking's bugging me in the truck. That means it's coming through real loud on the video, because the video is always so much worse than it is in real life, and it's pretty bad in real life right now. So that means you guys probably can't even hear me talk over that squeaking. But anyway, all right, let's get down the road. Still don't know how far I'm gonna get, but it's early, so I'm kind of excited. We're gonna get going, man. We're gonna truck this thing right now. I got plenty of time on my clock. I got plenty of opportunity to get myself towards home, and have some flexibility tomorrow with how I do things and when I deliver and all of that stuff, when I get my hours reset and all that. So I'm excited. So let's get down this road. Woohoo! All right, we are trucking right along. We are on Highway 58. And as is fairly common on this highway, there's some serious crosswinds happening. So it is a little bit of a butt-puckering situation. I mean, I feel pretty comfortable because I do have over 20,000 pounds in the trailer. I don't feel like I'm at risk of getting blown over, unless there's a substantial gust that's significantly higher than the rest of the wind. But it's still kind of fighting me, pushing me around the lane a little bit, and it is strong enough to kind of like keep an eye on that trailer and try and make sure you don't do anything no sudden movements on the steering wheel. You don't want the wind to catch it just right, because even though I feel fairly confident, I could be wrong. Wouldn't be the first time I'd be wrong about something. So gotta get through Mojave and up past the scale right there, and towards Tehachapi, and the wind usually dies down a little bit once you get up into that pass. But down here in the high desert, it's just howling. It's always a crosswind. You know, it's never like a tailwind. Couldn't be a good tailwind. It's always a crosswind on Highway 58. So anyway, we'll keep on trucking along. If it gets to the point where I feel unsafe, I'm not afraid of pulling over. I've done it before. We've done this song and dance over the top of the Grapevine one time when I had a really light load. It was like 5,000 pounds or something like that. And I parked it for the night. So I won't push it. Not worth, you know. Getting blown over. I mean, can you imagine? Not just like the safety part of it. Of course, like, you know, you could get hurt. But can you imagine? Like, I'd have to get a job. Like, even if insurance covered it, everything was good, it would take so much time to get the trailer and the truck back to me. I'd have to take a job somewhere. I'd have to take a job as a company driver somewhere until I could get the truck back on the road. Anyway, yeah, so we won't push it. But like I said, I'm not really worried about it right now. It's just kind of, it's noticeable. There's some gusts that are blowing the trailer around a little bit, but not tipping it over, or not, you know, it's not catching the wind like that. It's just getting blown, you know, left to right in the lane. Not like that crazy, like, whoa, I feel like it's about to blow over type of feeling. So if I get that feeling, I will definitely pull over. Find somewhere to park where I can head into the wind. You don't want to park, you know, broadside to the wind. That would defeat the purpose of stopping. So you'll still get blown over if you're just sitting there. But, yeah. Keep on trucking along. Just passed Kramer Junction just now, and this Love's up here is a good place to stop and use the restroom and maybe get another beverage. But then again, outside of Fresno, I stopped over there in Boron at the Loves just after the last update, and I just the wind kind of wasn't quite as bad. There was a lot of trucks pulled over, so there was not very many places to park. I think that wind was howling earlier in the evening, even worse than it was when I went through there. So a lot of trucks pulled over to stop, take their time off, take some naps, whatever. And then I looked at the timing that I had as far as if I had enough time on my clock to get home, and I'll have just enough time. So I decided, you know what, we're just gonna truck it all the way to the yard. I would have rather actually stopped and slept, but If I reset the hours, or even if I did a sleeper berth split, it just would have been awkward tomorrow to get home, you know, drive like 3.5 hours, get home, and then take like 6 hours off, and then so I would have been doing another sleeper berth split for the next day. And I wanted to make sure that I had fresh hours for tomorrow. And it's not even as much for tomorrow as it is for the next day, but just once you start, you know, breaking up your time off into 5 hour chunks and 6 hour chunks, you never get a reset in. You never get, you know, a full 10 off. So it doesn't work out. It doesn't work out. The math just doesn't work out. Now, if I was able to just stop and sleep whenever I wanted to, I would have slept a long time ago. But I'm going to rock it all the way through. We're going to get all the way home. I'm gonna probably not get into my bed until like 4:30 in the morning, but you know what? It's not the first time I would have to stay up late to go trucking because the FMCSA sucks. All right, almost there. We'll get there and then we'll wrap this video up. All right, you suckers. We made it back to the yard. And like I said, rather than stopping and taking like a 4 or 5 hour nap, the FMCSA doesn't allow for 4 or 5 or 6 hour breaks. They don't make allotments for those. So I'm gonna get the same amount of sleep, get home at the same time as I would have. I'm gonna sleep 5 hours in my bed and then wake up today at about 10:30. Or I could have slept, you know, when I first started feeling tired, and slept for 5 hours and then made the rest of my drive, but FMCSA regulations won't allow that. So you gotta get some Mountain Dew and you gotta push through all the way to your destination and then take your time off, because that's what's allowable. That's the only way you can get to where you're going safely. Yeah, my butt. Anyway, I've been big on this hours of service thing because every time I'm recording with you guys and I'm driving into the, like, crazy hours of the morning, I gotta remind you guys that I'm not doing this by choice. This is like not the way that I would like to run. I would like to stop and get some sleep and then wake up early and go, but that's not the way that they make the rules, man. It's not the way that they make the rules. They make the rules so that dispatchers can't force drivers to do crazy stuff, but you know, their attempts to make things safer make it more dangerous for a lot of us. So anyway, all right, that's it for this video. We're gonna wake up tomorrow, well, today, and make this delivery tonight and all that, but that'll be on the next video. So stay tuned for that one. And yeah, we woke up this morning in yesterday morning, whatever you want to call it, yesterday afternoon, St. George, Utah. Picked up in Henderson. Oh, got the truck washed in North Las Vegas. Picked up in Henderson. Drove it to Northern California. So just got to make it over Pacheco Pass down into Gilroy tomorrow. We'll make our delivery. I keep saying tomorrow, but it's tonight because it's already morning time. But the sun's not up. I got to race home and get in bed before the sun comes up, because that makes me feel like I just went to bed really late instead of feeling like I stayed up all night. So that's the plan right now. Got to go. Got to run. Love you guys. Peace out.